channel today. And if you guys haven't read the title of this video, you guys probably didn't know that this video is going to be a how to make your very own YouTube channel banner art. Wow, that was like a mouthful in itself. I'm sure that title is like really long right now. But before we go ahead and get started, I wanted to let you guys know, if you guys haven't been following me on Twitter or Instagram or Facebook, I just graduated UCLA, UCLA, I just graduated. I know how hard it is to make your own channel banner art. I struggled. This time, I feel like my channel banner is like 20 times more awesome than my old one. And if you guys, you know, like this video and wanted me to do more videos like this, then give this video a big fat thumbs up. And if we can get 3,000 thumbs up today, like the first day this video is up, if we can get 3,000, you guys would literally make my day and week and month and summer in general. So definitely thumbs it up if you guys haven't. Do it now, like stop this video, thumbs up now. Yeah, okay, let's go ahead and get started, guys. All right, you guys, the first thing you want to do is go to the very top right-hand corner of your channel and go edit channel art. From there, you're gonna click the button that says how to create channel art, and then you'll be redirected to a different page. From here, you're gonna scroll down and you're gonna click the channel art templates that's right below this weird looking picture. So now I have the channel art templates and you have two versions. They're exactly the same, but one you can use on PicMonkey and the other you can use on Photoshop. So from there, you can open PicMonkey.com. I absolutely love PicMonkey because it's free. So from here, you're gonna go to the edit button, which is in the very top, very left corner. And then you're going to find your template that you just downloaded from YouTube. Just to explain what all of this means on your computer right now, it's pretty much showing you how your channel art is going to look like on a desktop versus a tablet versus an iPhone versus a TV. So the first thing I like to do is I like to go to the butterfly button, which is the overlays button right here. And then I go to geometric. I really hate the look of all this gray area, and I like to work with a really clean slate. And we're gonna place this right above the text and logo safe area. So you wanna work within this darkest gray box. So now that you have your text and logo safe area bordered up, you're gonna wanna go to the very crop button at the top. So it's this little square, and you're gonna push canvas color right here. I like to work with a white canvas, so I'm gonna apply that to the canvas. So I'm gonna open up Google search right now. So I'm gonna put in Tumblr backgrounds. So once I search Tumblr backgrounds, I wanna go to the search tools, and for the size, I wanna make sure that it's a large size just so it doesn't look pixelated when you enlarge it, and it's gonna work with everything. So now that I have Tumblr backgrounds, large sizes, I can look through all of the backgrounds that fit this category. And so the first one that really pops out to me is this black and white background right here. I think it looks so cool. So I'm just gonna save this image. Now I'm gonna go back into PicMonkey.com and I'm gonna go to the overlay button again, which is the butterfly button. And for the overlays, you can create your own. And I'm gonna drag in that cityscape background I just downloaded from Google. As you can see, when I grab the overlay and I just move it around, it sits on top of the border we made. What you wanna do is right click and send to back. But again, you wanna make sure that you extend your design a little bit more out than you would think you'd need it. So I like the position that this is in right now, and I think it looks kind of bland just being black and white. So I wanna add some sort of depth to it. I wanna add a watercolor effect, and I looked up watercolor backgrounds. And this is really easy to do. I looked up so many ways to do it, and I just figured out my own way to do it. So I'm actually just gonna download this one. So now you're gonna go back to PicMonkey.com, and again, you're gonna open up another overlay. So I'm gonna find that watercolor background that we just downloaded, and this is the one that I ended up liking the most. And as you can see right now, it just sits on top of the overlay and borders once again, and you don't want that. So you're gonna click on your background and you're gonna choose one of the blend modes. There's like 10 blend modes, but you can just play around with it. So for right now, I really like lighten. And as you can see, if I enlarge this picture, all of a sudden the cityscape is just pretty and it has color, and it's so much better than just being black and white and gray. So you wanna cover up all of your background. And then as you can see, once again, it just messes with your borders. So you're gonna send this to the back. All of a sudden, the effect disappears. So you're gonna click your cityscape and then send this to the very back. So now it's sitting behind the watercolor. All right, that looks pretty cool. So I'm happy with that. And you just wanna close it out. So now here's the really fun part. This is the time you can just make your background and channel art a little bit more personalized. So you're gonna go to the text effect, and then now you can add your channel name, your channel description, anything that you really wanna add, honestly. So I'm gonna add text, and I'm just gonna put my name, and this is going to make sure that everyone knows whose channel they're on. So mine is Miss Tiffany Mott. So I'm gonna go through my fonts and see which fonts I like the most. So Jennifer Lynn looks definitely like a handwriting that I have. So we're gonna make sure that it's, again, inside the black borders, because anything outside the borders is going to be hidden. So next thing you're gonna do is add a description about your channel on your channel art. So you can do new videos every week, something that'll tell people who just visited your page what your channel is all about. So I do lifestyle and fashion videos. So I'm gonna say lifestyle and fashion vids for the coolest internet kids. Now it's a little off center, and that's because I wanna add an arrow right here. So if you wanna add an arrow, PicMonkey also has arrow overlays. I personally don't like the arrows they choose for you, because the good ones aren't free and the free ones are terrible. And you wanna look up arrow overlays. And honestly, just choose any arrow that you think looks pretty neat. I'm gonna show you guys how to delete an overlay, or how to just erase parts of an overlay that you don't like. Okay, so as you can see, there are a ton of arrows here. You can only use one, because there's no reason I need 5 different overlays. So while you clicked your overlay button, you wanna go to eraser right here, and then I'm gonna start deleting the ones I don't like. And right now you guys can see that you can still see the white from the overlay, and it's really easy to just get rid of that. All you're gonna do is, again, go to one of the blend modes and blend it. Multiply is a good one, and so is darken if you wanna just get rid of the white. And then this arrow is pointed the wrong way, so I'm just gonna point that the right way. All right, so that is pretty much how you make your channel banner art. All you gotta do is just delete these black boxes, and you're pretty much done with your freaking cool ass new channel banner art. And then you're gonna go back to your profile on YouTube, edit channel art, select a photo from your computer, and then find the file that you just saved. Okay, so here's a tip, because a lot of you guys have told me in the past that your white background looks a little bit orange or yellowish, and that's because sometimes YouTube auto enhances it. So you wanna make sure you unclick this button and then you push select. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm so stoked on my new channel art. Definitely give this video a big thumbs up if you guys enjoyed it. But yeah, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye everyone. All right, so I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did use this video to make your channel banner, I wanna see it. So tag me at Miss Tiffany Mall on Instagram or Twitter. I absolutely love it when you guys actually do the DIYs, or like stuff that I show you guys how to do. It makes me really excited, because I feel like people are actually finding my videos helpful. Let's go ahead and let you guys peace out. Don't forget to subscribe if you guys are new, like this video if you haven't already, rate and comment and subscribe and share, and what else can you do? I don't know. Maybe you guys can like follow me on Twitter and Instagram too, at Miss Tiffany Ma. Ha! Okay, shameless plug, I'm sorry you guys. You guys are probably really annoyed at that. But I'm excited to talk to you guys, because I have so much free time now, and I'm so excited for everything I have planned for you guys. But my roomie is in the kitchen, and I feel really awkward when I'm like talking out loud and then someone's nearby. So I'm gonna let you guys go ahead. I love you guys. Peace out.